Southern Transport's depot at Aldenham in Hertfordshire, one of the new type buses prepares to go through the mill. A 56-seater, 6 inches wider than the old kind, it's about to be a recruit for a London queue. At London Transport's depot at Aldenham in Hertfordshire, one of the new type buses prepares to go through the mill. A 56-seater, 6 inches wider than the old kind, it's about to be put through an elaborate stability test. Ministry of Transport regulations lay down that every double-decker bus must be able to tilt to 28 degrees without turning over. It's worth remembering that whenever you're scared, your bus may tip when taking a corner. In just a second, the 10-ton giant, that is the tilting weight, is going to be right on edge. The bus stands on a platform to which is fitted indicators for registering degrees of tilt. Next, the upper deck is loaded with sandbags, 1.5 hundredweight representing one passenger, nearly 2 tons weight all told. Plates are removed from the outside wheels to allow tire pressures to be checked. Now it's a long pull at the chains and the bus starts to lean over like a toy boat in a gale. The test engineers make it twice as tough as necessary on the bus. You wouldn't get a tilt like this short of an excursion round the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Degrees of tilt for the chassis, 34 for the body, and the bus is all but balancing on edge. And here's how safe it is even now, as Chief Tester Fosdick joins the 80 sandbags stacked up there on the upper deck. Steady as a rock, yet there's a full house. At this angle, the bus is stabilized by its own weight, a tribute to perfect design and manufacturing. So nicely balanced that even a finger's pressure can swing it. Tests such as this are carried out behind the scenes and before a new design of bus ever takes the road. The guarantee of safety behind every ticket.
These Leyland Titans were the direct result of post-war standardization by London Transport. They were well engineered, efficient and reliable, and joined St Paul's and Tower Bridge as icons of London.